We want to demonstrate practical the way it should be done.
Calculation of equilibrium of forces. Example 7. Find the forces P and Q in the diagram below. There are two pivots here, pivot B and pivot C. This is AB is equal to 100 centimeter. The weight of the B is acting downward at the center, and it is 10 N. We are directed to find the forces here and the forces at B and C. And we denote this as P and Q. Draw the free body diagram. Free body diagram of this B, and it will be like this. Forces in the weight we have downward at the center. These two forces are this support. P will be here. Q will be here. The distance between them, this is 118. The distance between P and Q is 20 centimeters. The distance between 10 N and Q, this is P, this is Q, is 30 centimeter. This is A, this is B. Now, we are directed to find this force and this one. When you are given a problem like this, it resembles this diagram. In this diagram, this is pivot Q. This is pivot P, and this is 10 Newton. The weight is 10 Newton. This weight is 10 Newton. Acting downward at the center, there is another mass here. So we are going to resolve to find P and Q now. How are we going to do this? Summation of all the moments. Since we want to find out P force, we take moment about Q. So when we say about the moment Q, we equal to zero. Clockwise moment, we equal to positive. Clockwise moment means the direction of movement of clock. So this one, so clockwise direction is going to be positive, and moment is given by force times perpendicular distance. We are going to take them one by one. First of all, some upward forces must be equal to downward forces. These are the two upward forces, P and Q. P plus Q is equal to 10 Newton. That's equation one. Then we are now going to resolve P. If we assume that this is P, we are going to resolve it up to this point. P is the force, perpendicular distance from this one, from this P, the point of action here, up to this point. So this point will be, this point will be starting. Then we continue to move this P up. A time we call when it moves anti-clockwise like this. And this one will give us anti-clockwise direction. So P multiplied by the distance, perpendicular distance, 20 plus 30, 50. The next one is 10 Newton. Multiplied by perpendicular distance between 10 Newton and P is 30 centimeter. Everything will be equal to zero. This will be plus. This will be plus because this one will be pushing it down, down at a point which is tend to move clockwise direction, which is positive. For the first one, it's going to be negative. So this one will give us. This one will give us. Minus 50 p centimeter is equal to minus 300 n centimeter. So p will give us 300 Newton centimeter divided by 50. Negative will cancel negative. So centimeter. Centimeter will cancel out. Zero will cancel zero. P 5 to 30, 6.0 Newton. Now, from the first equation here, P plus Q is equal to 10 Newton. Since P is equal to 6 Newton plus Q is equal to 10 Newton. So Q will be equal to 10 Newton minus 6 Newton, which is equal to 4 Newton. Therefore, P is equal to 6 Newton and Q is equal to 4 Newton. Those are the two answers. Sum 8. Find the forces X and Y in the diagram below. This is the diagram. This is the first pivot X. This is the second pivot Y. The weight is 40 Newton, and another weight is angle here 20 Newton. Another one. 30 Newton. We can use this one to denote it. This is the beam. This is the weight in between. Acting downward at the center, 40 Newton. This is 20 Newton. This is 30 Newton. So now I will draw the free body diagram that will give us the opportunity to calculate it very well. This is the free body diagram F, B, D. We are going to transfer this distance down in between X and 20 Newton. We have 2 meters. We have 2 meters, that is the distance in between X and 40 Newton. We have 1 meter in between 40 Newton and Y. We have 2 meters in between Y and 30 Newton. We have 1.5 meter. Now, the first equation. Upward forces must equal to downward forces. Upward forces are x plus y, and downward forces are 20 Newton, 40 Newton, and 30 Newton. X plus y is equal to 90 Newton. Summation of four. We are going to find y first. We are going to find y first. So we take moment about x. Summation of moment about x is equal to zero. Clockwise moment is equal to positive. Moment is force times perpendicular distance. Now, let us start. We are going to start from the right hand side. The first one here is 30 Newton. 30 Newton, perpendicular distance from 30 Newton to X is 1.5 plus 2 meter plus 1 meter. That is 4.5 meter. 4.5 meter. The next one, but when you take moment about this point will be static. While you pull this force down, let's demonstrate it here. Let's demonstrate it here. This is our y. This one will be static. We now continue to pull this force down. Down. It will come to a point that it will act as if it is moving in a clockwise direction. And the clockwise direction here is positive. So we are going to have positive here. The next one is y. The perpendicular distance from y to x, where we take moment, is 2 plus 1, 3 times 3 meter. And to note the symbol here, this is y, this is y, we are taking moment from x, it is pointing upward, it will be moving like this, up, it will come up to a point that it will move to the anticlockwise direction. Anticlockwise direction is equal to negative, according to this clock. Now, the next one is 40 Newton. 40 Newton, perpendicular distance between 40 Newton, the point of action and line of action is 1 meter. That's 1 meter. So, since it is moving anticlockwise, it will be inside here will be negative. No. 40 meters. 40 will be positive, sorry. 40 will be positive. This is 40. This is 40. So you move it down. down, that will be positive, clockwise direction. Y is moving up. Now the next one is 20 newtons. Since we are taking moment about x, we are not going to take into consideration x because moment is force times perpendicular direction. The force is x, the distance is zero because the point of action is the same thing as line of action there. So the next one is 20 newton. 20 newton times perpendicular distance between 20 newton and x is 2 meter times 2 meter. 2 meter. Everything will be equal to zero according to this equation. So now to know the symbol in front of it, this is 20 newton. It will be moving down. Y, this is the point we are taking moment. This one will be pulling it down, down. A point you call is the same as if it's going anti-clockwise. And anti-clockwise, according to this diagram, is negative. Everything is equal to zero. Now we are going to take them one by one. We are going to take them one by one. Now, 30 times 4.5 will give us 135 newton meter. Y times 3 meter will give us 3y meter. 40 times 1 will give us 40 newton meter. 20 times 2 will give us 40 newton meter. Everything will be equal to zero according to this equation. Summation of moment about the point is equal to zero. This plus 40 newton will cancel this 40 newton. This is positive, this is negative. So minus 3y meter is equal to minus 135 newton meter. Y is equal to minus 135 newton meter divided by 3 meter. Meter will cancel meter. 3 here 1, 3 here 4, 3 times 4, 12, 3 in 15, 5. So Y is equal to 45 newton. Now, from the first equation here, x plus y is equal to x plus y is equal to 90 newton. Y is 45. X plus 45 is equal to 90 newton. X is equal to 90 newton minus 45 newton. X will be equal to 45 newton. Y will also be equal to 45 newton. Those are the forces at these two supports at X and Y. Example 9. A uniform rod 1 meter long of mass 50 gram is supported horizontally on two knife edges. Place 10 centimeters from its ends. What will be the reactions at this support when a 100 gram mass is suspended 10 centimeters from the midpoint of the rod? This is how the diagram will look like. This is the pivot. Let me first of all draw it here. Let's draw it. The two knife edges placed 10 centimeters from the edges. This is one. This is another one. Another knife edge. Then, what is the reaction at this for support when 100 grams is suspended 10 centimeters from the midpoint? This is the midpoint. The weight will act downward. So 100 grams will be 10 centimeters from the center. This one, this is how it will look like. F, this is A, this is B, this is 100 gram, 50 gram, this is F, C, F, D, force at C, force at D. So that is, this is the physical presentation of the question. These are the two pivots. These are the two pivots. This is the weight acting downward at the center. This is 100 gram, 10 centimeter from the 10 centimeter from the center. This is 10 centimeter here. 10 centimeter here. Since weight act downward at the center, half of 100 centimeter will be 50. If from here to here is 10, and from here to here is 50, from here to here will be 40 centimeter. If from here to here, 100 gram, okay, 100 gram mass is suspended 10 centimeter from the midpoint. This is the midpoint. This is 10 centimeter. Then from midpoint to this point is 50 centimeter. If from here to here is 10, from here to here is 10, we are going to subtract 10 plus 10, 20 from 50. So this this will be 30 centimeter. With that now, we are going to draw the free body diagram. Our free body diagram for this one will look like this. This is the free body diagram. So according to the diagram, here will be 10 centimeter, 40 centimeter, 10 centimeter, 30 centimeter, 10 centimeter. When we add everything together, it must be 1 meter. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. 10 plus 40, 50 plus 10, 60 plus 30, 90 plus 10. 100 centimeter. So after that, this FC force that directed to calculate the reaction at this support. Reaction FC, this is 50 gram, this is 100 gram, this is FD, this is FD. Now, after that, We are going to calculate first here. So we confine this one to gram. 50 gram FC plus FD is equal to 50 gram plus 100 gram. That is 150 gram. So this one says 1000 gram is equal to 1 kilogram. 150 gram is equal to 1 kilo, 150 divided by 1000, which is 0.154 kilogram. So F is equal to mg. So that is 0.150 times 10 meter per second squared, which is 1.5 newton. So the total force acting downward is 1.5 newton. The total force, so this one will now become Fc plus Fd is equal to 1.5 newton. We can now calculate the reaction at Fc and Fg. This one will give us less take moment, summation of moment about G. We want to find Fc first, is equal to zero. Clockwise moment is equal to positive. Moment is force times perpendicular distance. Fc, we are starting from here. Fc, perpendicular distance from here to here is 40 plus 10, 50 plus 30, 80 centimeters. Since we are taking moment here and we are pushing it up, a time will come when the beam will bend toward clockwise direction. So the symbol here will be plus. The next one is 50 gram. 50 gram perpendicular distance from here to here is 10 plus 30. That is 40 centimeter. The symbol here, since you are taking moment here, this one will be static. You continue to pull it down. So time will come when it will become it will turn anti-clockwise, that is negative. Now, the last but not least, this is 100 gram. 100 gram multiplied by perpendicular distance between 100 gram and LD. That is 30 centimeters. Everything will be equal to zero according to this equation. So we are now going to multiply them together now. So this one will give us this one will be anti-clockwise, negative. So this one will give us 80 Fc centimeter minus 50 times 40 will give us 2000 gram centimeter. 100 times 300 will give us 3000 gram centimeter. Everything will be equal to zero. So this one will give us 80 Fc centimeter is equal to 2000 plus 3000, 5000 gram centimeter. So Fc, will give us 5000 gram centimeter divided by 80 centimeter. This centimeter will cancel this centimeter. This zero will cancel this zero. 8 times 6, 48. 8 in 10. 20. Sorry. 8:20. That is 2. 8:20 is 2. 8:4. 20. 8 + 3 is 16. 20 - 16 is 4. 8:45. So to give us 2.5 grams, which is 0.0625 kilogram. We divide this one by 1,000, it will give us 0.0625. X is equal to mg. Our m is 0.0625 times 10 meter per second square. So Fc is equal to 0.625 newton. Fc from this equation, Fc plus Fd is equal to 1.5 newton. So Fd is equal to 1.5 divided by 0.625 will give us 10 - 5, 5, 9 - 2, 7, this is 4, 6 from 14, 8, 0.875 90. That's Fd. So Fd is 0.875 Newton. Fc is 0.625 Newton. Now, example 10. A simple weighing machine is made of a uniform bar 125 cm long and mass 5 kg and pivoted 0.5 cm for one end. Find the mass that was suspended at the end of the long arm so as to balance a mass of 320 kg at the end of the short arm. The diagram of this question will look like this. Now, the bar from A to B is 125 cm long and is 2.5 cm from one end. Find the mass that was suspended at the end of the long arm. This is long arm in the air. Let's call the force FA. Since A is here, B is here. So as to balance a mass of 320 kg at the end of the short arm. This is the short arm. The way to act downward at the center. So now, the weight is spiked to the ground.
Yes, it.
Spiked to the ground. This 1320 kilograms of suspended at the end of the short arm, 320 kilograms is suspended here. This is 2.5 centimeters. This is the 5 foot. That's only 1 5 foot. Now, the weight must act at the center. Act downward. So from this point to this point will be 125 centimeters divided by 2. It gives us 62.5 centimeters. Since from here to here is 2.5 centimeters, this from the center to this pipe will be 60.2 centimeters. With this one now, we can start our calculation to get the mass. The mass here. So FA, or we can call it MA. Let's call it MA since it is mass. It's equal to it's equal to 5 kg plus 320 kg, which is equal to 325 kg. Now that is that. MC, we take moment about that point. M A multiply by the perpendicular distance from here to here, 62.5 plus 60 will give us 122.5 centimeter. So this one is acting downward. This is starting, you continue to pull it until you have an anti-clockwise direction. The symbol here will be negative. So the next one is 5 kilograms. The perpendicular distance will be 5 kilograms, and the point here we take our moment is 60 times 60 centimeters. This one will also be negative. And this will be starting to continue to pull it down until when we get to this one. So the next one is 320 kilograms. Multiply by 2.5 from here to here is 2.5 centimeter. Everything is equal to zero. So we can pull this one, push this one down, and this is starting. We can recall when it is called clockwise, and clockwise direction is equal to positive. So this one will be positive. So this one will have for 122.5. MA centimeter minus 5 times 60, 5 times 0.5 times 6, 300 kilogram centimeter plus 320 times 2.5 give us 800 kilogram centimeter. Everything will equal to zero. When we remove 300 from 800, we have 500 minus 122.5 MA centimeter is equal to 300 from 800, we have plus 500 kilogram centimeter is equal to 0. So minus 122.5 LA centimeter is equal to minus 500 kilogram centimeter. So LA will be equal to minus 500 kilogram centimeter divided by 122.5 centimeter. Centimeter will cancel out. This is negative. Negative will cancel out negative. M will now be equal to 4.0 kilogram. 4.0 kilogram. Example 11. A uniform rod AB, 180 cm long, of mass 2 kg. It's balanced horizontally on a simple support when carrying load of 1 kg and 3 kg at distance of 60 and 120 cm, respectively, from A. Find the position of the support and the magnitude of the downward forces on it. The diagram will look like this. The weight we add downward at the center, the weight is 2 kg. Yes. The weight is 2 kg. Now, the weight is 2 kg to act downward at the center. From here, this is A. From A to B is 180 cm. So when a load of 1 kg and 3 kg at distance of 60 are 120 cm respectively from A, then there will be 1 kg will be here, 2 kg will be here. We are going to fix the support with somewhere here. That is MT. So, in order to locate the position from here to here, with the X, this empty, this is 1 kg, this is 3 kg. This the distance from here to here is 60 centimeters. Since the center is the mass at the center, from here to here will be 30 centimeters. So from here, find the from here to here. From here to here is 120 centimeter. Now, we are going to find the upward forces, I mean mass, Mt. Mt is equal to 1 plus 2 plus 3. Kilogram, which is equal to 6 kilogram. Now, the magnitude of the downward force here will be Mt. This is mg, mass that accelerates due to gravity, which is equal to 1 plus 2 plus 3 kilogram times 10 meter per second squared. This one, Ft, is equal to 60 Newton, 60 Newton. Now, solution of all four moments about A, we are taking moment about this point, is equal to zero. Clockwise moment is equal to positive, and total moment is equal to force times perpendicular, force times perpendicular distance. So let's take them one by one. We are taking moment about this point. We are moving from here to this place. The first one is 3 kilogram. This 3 kilogram, distance between 3 kilogram and A is 120 centimeter times 120 centimeter. This one is going to be positive because if this is static, I continue to push it down the time it comes when it should move anti-clockwise. I mean, it should move clockwise, and clockwise moment is equal to positive. I mean, clockwise direction is equal to positive. So this will be positive. The next one is Lt. Lt times x. Lt is 6 kilogram times x. 6 kilogram times x. This one is going to be anti-clockwise. Anti-clockwise direction. If this is static, I continue to push it up. The time it comes when the beam will move anti-clockwise direction. So this is going to be negative. The next one is 2 kilograms. The mass of the beam of the rod, the mass of the rod, 2 kilograms. Distance between these 2 kilograms and the point A is 30 centimeter plus 60 centimeter. That is 90 centimeter. 90 centimeter. And this one is going to be positive because as you push it down, the time will come when the beam will move in a clockwise direction. Clockwise direction is equal to positive. So this will be positive. the mass or not the disc is this 1 kilogram. 1 kilogram. 1 kilogram times distance between here and here is 60 centimeter. 60 centimeter. So let's add the single here is positive. Since we are pushing it down, and this one is static, it can recall when the rod will move in a clockwise direction. And clockwise direction is equal to positive. So let's multiply them together. 3 times 120, 360 kilogram centimeter minus 6 x kilogram centimeter plus 180 kilogram centimeter plus 1 kilogram times 60 kilogram centimeter. Everything is equal to zero. So this is 360, 180, 60, 180 plus 60. It give us 240, so 360 kilogram centimeter, 180 plus 60, 240, plus 240 kilogram centimeter minus 6x kilogram centimeter is equal to zero. So this one will give us 360 plus 240, that is 600 kilogram, 600 kilogram centimeter minus 6x kilogram centimeter is equal to zero. Minus 6x kilogram centimeter is equal to minus 600 kilogram centimeter. So x is equal to minus 600 kilogram centimeter divided by 6 kilogram. This kilogram will cancel. This kilogram will cancel off minus 6. So x will be 6 here, 1 here, 100. So x will equal to 100.00 centimeter. The position of the support here, x is equal to 100 centimeter. Magnitude of downward forces is equal to 16 newton.